Buddy, today we're gonna talk about how to connect the batteries in series or parallel. Do you know how to do it? What's the pros and cons, and what can be improved about them? All right, so let's get started. What are the most common batteries used today in small to medium electronics and how we can improve them? And there is a universal battery. First thing first, you know, AAA batteries like this one you can see here. And you see the application of this one is in clock, remote, smoke alarms, torches and so on. Next one in line is AA batteries. As you can see, comparison with this one, the AAA is thinner and the AA is a little bit bulkier. You see, this is the comparison between these two of them. And as well, this one are used in remote control, smoke detectors, small application to medium power, torches, phones, and so on. Next is this button cell. You can use it in a remote control like this one, small watches, thermometers and so on. By the way, did you know that this one is 1.5 volts as well and type 1? Here you go, this is 1.5 volts as well. So here you go, in comparison, you see? So each and every application has got different batteries to suit their needs. Next in line is this 9 volt battery, which is very useful as well and very powerful. This one can power the multimeters and all sorts of devices. The thing that's special with this battery is got this connector here, which can allow them to be stitch them together like so. On the other end, onto the rechargeable kind of things, are these lithium ion cell or 18650, which are very popular these days because they have a life expectancy more and longer than these regular ones and can be used in loads of application as well. A short example with two of this one and a battery pack like so, we can make the equivalent of 9 volts battery, which is gonna be more powerful than this one. So this one equal with this one in voltage, but in capacity is 10 times bigger. So, and last but not least, the 12 volts lead acid battery, which has various of application from solar to starting your car to UPS to inverters and so on. And by the way, do you know that this one, this tiny thing, is a 12 volts as well? Here you go, have a take a closer look of this stuff. Is a 827, so it's a 12 volts as well. And by the way, there is another kind of 12 volts. So here you go, it's about this stuff being so small, huh? Or maybe you do, but here you go, 12 volts as well, but different application, different size, different matter. Alright, so let's get back to our topic. Alright, so let's continue with the thing. This 12 volts battery is nothing else than a couple of 2 volts batteries, small one, put it in series. In series, what it means? Connecting batteries in series means like we're gonna stack them together with plus, minus, plus and minus, and we're gonna have a total voltage of the sum of how many batteries we're gonna put in series. Like you're gonna see here, I'm gonna put the multimeter. Here we go, 4.5 should be, but because this is 1.5 batteries, we're gonna have like more, 5 volts, nearly. Yeah, so this is what means putting batteries in series. Putting batteries in series, like here, we're gonna make a small line of batteries and we're gonna have a greater potential at the end of this one. So the sum of these 3 batteries added together is gonna give us 3 volts, but the amperage is gonna be the same. We only manage to increase the voltage. The same is gonna be applicable in the 18650 volts cell. We're gonna stack them together, plus and minus, minus and plus, like so, and we have a pack or a series battery connected. this is going to be the same. The total voltage of these batteries in series is going to be the sum of each individual cell. We can add them together, or if it's the same value, we're going to multiply by the number of them, and we're going to have the series connection voltage of the total battery pack. In some application, in order to connect these batteries in a battery pack as well, 12 volts, 9 volts, and so on, we're gonna have a special battery holders. Like in this one as well, in a common, in a flashlight like this, in a small smiley face thing, you can see this battery holder here for AA 1.5 volts. So you see this pack is got like 1, 2, 3, and 4. Four batteries connected all together is gonna make this LED lamp to glow. Alright, so we know by now how to connect the batteries in series and why we do need this, because each and every appliances is gonna need different voltage. So by this, by doing this, adding voltage by voltage, you know, 9 volt, 12 volt, 24 volt, 48 or so on, we're gonna make the powerment required for our specific application. One more thing, connecting the batteries in series like this is gonna increase the voltage, but the power is gonna be the same. The power, think it like this, you know, amperage or amps is gonna be the same thing. But if we're gonna connect the batteries in parallel connection, which is like so, any terminal, you know, any plus terminal, think it this way. We have a common thing and we're gonna connect all our minuses back together, you see? So all the minuses are joined in one center point, and all the positive, like this one, is gonna be on a center point. But the common arrangement of the parallel batteries is gonna be like so. Pluses on one side and minuses on the other side. What this one doesn't increase the voltage. The voltage stays the same, but it increases the total power or output of it, you know. So as you can see, this one is fatter, so more powerful, but the voltage stayed the same. This one in series is longer, which has got more voltage, but the power is 3/4 than a parallel one. All right, so this is the analogy between parallel and series connections. All right, now we did talk about just the benefits, but the downside of connecting batteries in series in parallel is that if the pack is not well balanced, or through time, overdischarge, overcharge, or so, this battery pack is gonna get unbalanced. And when this one happens, you know, this one gets higher, this one gets lower, then all the battery is gonna have to suffer. Another connection of batteries is mixed connection or series to parallel connection. As you can see here, we got a series connection. If we're gonna bring another series connection, we have two series connections, right? But if we're gonna parallel them together, we're gonna have a mixed connection. Series on this side, but parallel on the other side. This is the common battery output or setup for your laptop batteries, which is gonna have inside, in most of the laptops, 98% or so, is gonna have like 6 batteries in pair of 2, weld them together in parallel, and then put them in series. And this one is gonna give us like 11.1 volts, or rounded up together, 12 volts connection. That was it, friends, a brief discussion on how to connect batteries in series and parallel, the pros and cons, and what makes our batteries to diminish after a while. Alright, so if you wanna check out how to use a multimeter and all sorts of battery pack related, 9 volts and 20 volts, how to make yourself ones, check it out, this playlist here and on the description below. In the meanwhile, thumbs up, subscribe, share this fun, and see you on the next one. Yeah, batteries!